crazy theory about Gion and the old man from the show Squid Games.
All right, let's hear it.
So remember how close the old man was to Gion?
Yeah.
So there's a theory that the old man is actually the dad of Gion.
Wait, what?
So in episode 3, Gion asks for chocolate milk when the workers are handing out regular milk because he's allergic to dairy.
And then the old man says, I'm willing to bet as a kid you got spanked a lot. And then Gion says, how'd you know that? Then the old man says, my son did too. He was just like you, friend. Wait, what the? He's basically saying that he's exactly like his son.
And then when they're playing the marbles game, the old man says,
you know, when I was a kid, I lived in a neighborhood just like this. And then Gion says, so did I.
And then when the old man starts to lose his memory, he asks Gion, what day is it?
And he says, is today the 24th?
Because his son's birthday is in a couple days. And guess what day Gion's birthday is?
What?
At the beginning of the show, when Gion's trying to get money out of the ATM, he types in his birthday as a pin. And his birthday is April 26th. Just a couple days after the 24th, just like the old man's son.
Stop it.
This is my theory of Squid Game.
Squid Game theory. Spoiler alert. Okay, so this is another theory about how the Red Mask Guards are recruited. The theory is that the players who decided not to return to the game are now working as Red Mask Guards. After the majority of voters discontinued playing and went back to the outside world, 187 out of the 201 remaining players returned back to the game. That leaves 14 people who decided not to return to the game because they didn't want to put their own life at risk. Frontman said to keep an eye on those who didn't return. He said this because they will be given another opportunity to return to the game and repay the debt, but as a Red Mask Guard. For the players who didn't return, the main concern is that life will be at risk. As a Red Mask Guard, your own life won't be at risk as long as you don't break any rules, for example taking off your mask, and they can earn a lot of money once they complete their contracted time. It's also a way to prevent them from leaking all of the crazy things happening inside to the outside world. If you add those 14 people who refused to return this year, with all those who refused to return in previous years, it would add up to more than 100 at least, which is kind of consistent with the number of guards. Do you think there's any connection between the players and the Red Mask Guards?
Okay, this comment right here is actually a good support to the theory as well. Spoilers for all of Squid Game if you have not seen it yet. And if you haven't seen it yet, go watch it. So I've thought about this, and my theory for Season 2 is that Jiyun is actually going to go undercover as a worker in the games. Just like how the detective went undercover, but this time he's going to try to take it down. When Jiyun plays the first game, he's wearing a blue hat. And he becomes a player later. At the end of the show, he dyed his hair red. But he's decided to go back to the show and take it down. He can't go in as a player, so he has to come in as a worker. Now let's take a second to talk about the workers, because I think you guys are confused. Remember, there are ranks when it comes to the workers. Circles are workers, they do not carry guns, they are given instructions by their superiors, but they don't actually kill people, they're the ones that burn the bodies. Triangles are the soldiers, they are the ones that kill. While the squares are basically like second in commands. Yes, these shapes come from the Squid Game. Listen, if you were offered money to be a worker, you would do it.
More crazy things that everyone missed about the old man from Squid Game.
There's no way there's more stuff.
Okay, so remember when the old man gets his blanket taken away and it looks like he peed his pants?
Yeah.
So I saw a video by Ruth Bell, and if you look closely to where the old man is laying down, there's an empty water bottle by his head. And the theory is that the old man poured the water bottle on himself to test if Gion would help him, just like he tested him in the marble game.
I didn't even notice there was a water bottle there.
And remember when the detective is going through all the files? He sees the list of all the players from 2020, but when he turns to the first page, it starts with the number 002. And the page for the old man's number, 001, was the only one missing out of all the players. And remember early in the season when all the fighting broke out in the main room?
It literally reminded me of the Hunger Games. It was crazy.
Right, and when the old man started screaming like, please stop, the front man saw that he was actually scared. So then he stopped all the fighting.
I still can't believe how many hidden details there are in this show. It's crazy. There's a crazy theory that you could actually see how the old man cheats in Squid Game.
Well, I know when they were playing Red Light, Green Light, the old man was the only one that didn't get scanned by the robot.
Yeah, but there's something even crazier how the old man cheated. So Maxi Doxy did a video where he found this crazy detail during the Tug of War game. Remember how the old man helps Gion and everybody win the Tug of War game?
Yeah.
But did you see how all the players are like handcuffed and chained to the rope with locks?
Yeah, everyone had locks on like each of their wrists.
Right, but there's a crazy theory that the old man actually had special locks and he wasn't actually locked to the rope.
Wait, how?
So when Gion and the whole team wins Tug of War, right, they're all laying on the ground. But if you look at their wrists, they're all handcuffed to the rope still with locks on. But when you see the old man laying on the ground, he doesn't have locks on his wrist anymore. So the old man probably used fake locks just in case his team was about to lose. He would have just left and let go of the rope and moved out of the way.
Dang, he probably had fake locks then. Yeah, I figured out how the workers in Squid Game are hired.
Wait, really?
Yeah, I know you said the Dachi cards determine who the workers are, but they turned out to be someone else. So remember when the detective is going through the front man's room and he sees all the files of all the players and winners of Squid Game throughout the years?
Yeah.
And we know all the contestants are in debt because of gambling and other stuff like that. But there's a theory that all the workers are actually past winners of Squid Game that gambled all their money away and went back into debt. So they were then offered to be a worker because it would be unfair for them to go back and play a game they've already won. And we know the games are all about equality and fair chance.
That makes a lot of sense.
And the reason why they're not hesitant to kill anyone is because they're past winners, so they've already seen so many people die and be killed when they played. And we also get to see what some workers look like. Like, some are old and some are young, just like the contestants of the game.
It's crazy to me how good of a show Squid Game is.
On what's gonna happen in Squid Game Season 2. Spoiler alert. Hajun, the policeman, is still alive. When he got shot, he was shot in his right chest and not his heart. Plus, when he fell down the cliff, technically we did not see him die on screen. So, he will appear again. Yes! And it's possible that maybe he lost his memory and returns as a player, goes into the game, and finds out that his memories come back. Next, at the end, they were given a variety of food for the three remaining players left, right? They never really mentioned where they got the fruit from. There's a high chance that the food they're eating is actually the dead bodies of other players. In other words, cannibalism. And lastly, Jennie from Blackpink seems to be quite involved with behind the scenes. And she's recently been liking a lot of their posts and everything. So what if she joins Squid Game in Season 2? And what if the other Blackpink players do as well? Share this video if you want that to happen.